Hello, this is Bern, and if there's sparks of electricity between you and a guy and you get so excited to get to know him and all of a sudden he goes from hot to lukewarm and then cold, meaning he stops pursuing you, I'm gonna share the only thing you have to do as a high value woman to get the love you want into your life in that situation. My promise is that by the end of this video, if you do what I'm sharing, you will never again feel crappy if a guy loses interest in you. Welcome to BernMendez.com. If this is your first time here and you want to learn how you can attract your ideal life partner without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or silly techniques, make sure to hit the subscribe button so you can be notified of new episodes as they come out. If it's been a while since you've met a guy who feels like a true match, it's especially painful when he loses interest in you, when he pulls back or stops texting or connecting with you. The biggest pain is the loss of your idea about him. It's similar to saying, well, my grandma were faster, she might be in the Olympics. If this guy were more committed, more capable, more into you, more compatible, he might be a great fit, but the reality is right now he isn't. So what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna share the only thing you need to do to change the dynamic and also four things you need to stop doing so that that one thing you do has its full effect. Before I step into the full video, if you're interested in attracting your ideal life partner well beyond what I can express in this video, if you hit the first link on the description of this video, you'll see a page that looks like this. If you enter your name and email, you can start watching my free masterclass to embody the changes in your experience instead of just your mind. Do you know what the odds are of winning the lottery? It's 1 in 13,983,816. Now, imagine that you go to your favorite comedian store at the end of the day, you buy a lottery ticket, you wake up the next day, only to find out that someone 100 miles away in a town you've never been to and in a store you've never been to bought the sole winning lottery ticket. Now, you start looking for yours just in case and you realize that you've lost it. And you start becoming frantic about losing a ticket that is not the winning ticket. You need to stop acting as if you lost the winning lottery ticket. When a guy disappears from your life, wasting doesn't have the decency or the expressiveness or the capacity to tell you why he's leaving, why he's disconnecting, it's not the best loss for you. You may have dodged a bullet, but so long as you think of it as the biggest prize you never won, you'll feel crappy inside. Step number two is you need to stop taking this personally. Imagine that you go to your favorite Mexican restaurant at the end of a really hard week. You go with four of your best girlfriends and you're having fun, enjoying food, so much so that you say, I'm gonna just have it all. And you have taquitos, chalupas, quesadillas, lots of salsa, and maybe even a few margaritas. And 30 minutes into the conversation, you feel the rumbling of a volcano about to erupt in your stomach. You go to the bathroom and you realize, I don't wanna do that here. This is just not the place for me. I need to go home and relieve myself. So you go back to your table, let your friends know that you have to leave. You're not really standing for small talk and you leave really quickly. Imagine if your friends start having a deep conversation about how they wronged you so badly that you have to leave. That's the same thing that happens when you start thinking about all the flaws that you have, the lack of expressiveness in you, maybe the flaws in your skin, your extra 5 pounds that you think he cares about, as the reason why he couldn't connect, without considering that maybe he's gay. Maybe he is in another relationship and he didn't share it with you. Maybe he's looking more for a friend with benefits and he didn't express it clearly enough. Maybe he has a very complicated problem that you're saving yourself from by not being with him, but he didn't care to share it with you. When you make this about you and think that the sun revolves around your orbit instead of recognizing that he has his own problems, his own reality, then you feel a sense of lack that is absolutely detrimental to your love life. A principle that can change your life for good is understanding that if a guy is intelligent, passionate, tall, strong, wealthy, spiritual in nature, candid and confident at the same time, but he's not interested in you or he can't pursue you, you can take all those qualities, multiply them by the number zero, and the result is always zero. That's the value that he brings to your life if he's not really into you. So stop thinking that you did something to push him away when in reality, he didn't have what he took from the beginning, you just didn't see it. Step number three is stop trying so desperately to get his attention, even in subtle ways, like sending him a quick message that you forgot something in his car. If you go through the weekend from Black Friday to Cyber Monday, you'll notice that there's quite a few brands that send you an insane number of emails trying to get your attention in a desperate attempt to get you to click and buy something that you're not interested in buying and have no intention of owning. That's the same thing that happens when you start trying to pursue the guy, to text the guy, to ask him why he's not connecting with you. Stop that in a second. A secret that you need to understand is if a man is interested in you and capable of pursuing you, he will do it without you needing to do absolutely anything other than showing up with your full radiance. If you're showing up fully radiant and he's not pursuing you, he's not doing what it takes, stop it. There's nothing you need to do in that situation. Feels like spam. Four is stop focusing on him and stop stalking him in social media. Imagine you decide to become way healthier and decide to stop consuming sugar. And as a strategy, you first go into Netflix to watch every single baking show, and then you take a trip to your favorite candy store and you touch all the candy and smell it, but don't intend to buy it. How does that work? You're gonna end up eating candy that is not good for you. If you want to move forward, stop connecting with him in social media, stop focusing on what he's doing, what he's saying, and focus instead in owning your greatness. There's two ways to think about the one thing you have to do to get what you want. The first one is absolutely nothing. Do absolutely nothing as it relates to this guy. If he wants to pursue you, he will. The second way of looking at it is the one thing to do is to step fully into an abundance mindset and way of being. Think about it. There's 3.9 billion men in the planet. And while not everybody's a fit for you, you have to imagine there has to be at least one who's more capable, more enthusiastic, more connected than he is, even if you can't see it right now. The way you step into abundance is three parts. Part number one is when you fall off the horse, the next best thing you can do is get on the horse again as quickly as possible, meaning put yourself out there again, start dating, focus on what's possible for you irrespective of this man. Number two is focus on anything and everything that makes you feel intensely alive. Instead of putting your attention on why it didn't work with him, start doing the things that make your life a masterpiece, an example for others to follow. Increase your sense of radiance and connectivity and passion, because that will make you feel far more attractive to the guy that you connect with next time around. And the third thing is, next time you connect with a man, express a little bit more of you. Put yourself out there more, share more of your thoughts and feelings, and stop projecting the future until you get to know him more deeply. If you find that this is helpful and you want to take the concepts of this video way further than I can explain in this few minutes, make sure to hit the first link in the description of this video so you can watch my free masterclass where you can understand how to take this beyond intellectual understanding into the embodiment in your heart and soul. If you like this video, click like, it's free, or a thumbs up, and subscribe to my channel to be notified of episodes as they come out. And if you want to share with me in a comment below, what is your biggest takeaway and your biggest commitment of something you want to change after watching this video, I would love to personally take a look at that. Thank you so much for connecting with me. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.